Good afternoon, dear students. Welcome to another session of computer. Here, last time we have seen few important concepts in OpenOffice Calc. We have already started chapter number 2, functions and charts in OpenOffice Calc, and I have shown you 3 examples regarding to drawing a graph or chart. Okay, let me revise in a quick succession. I will recapitulate within 2 minutes. Let me show you the same file. It is in front of you right now. Graph or chart is nothing but it is the pictorial representation of your data. How you can represent your data pictorial picture in the form of pictures. Similarly, pictures, these pictures or charts or graph are used to compare the data. I have shown you one example last time. It is in front of you right now on the screen. We have considered crop production in the year 2017, 18, 19, and 2020 for the crops wheat, bajra, and rice, and see the overall production in terms of tons is shown in the screen. So you can easily compare which crop has the highest yield in which year. Okay, similarly, we have considered one pie chart. Pie chart is used to represent percentage in terms of 100. So we have calculated a population of a particular city, how many males, females, and male, female, and children are there. So we have seen this example. After that, we have seen line graph, how the y is changing on the change of x. So x and y both are represented in terms of line. I have shown this to you. Now, I am going to start with today's topic called as sorting and filtering. For sorting the data, I have already created this table to save our time. Sorting the data means rearranging the data or reordering the data in a particular format. Okay, sorting is either ascending or descending. Ascending order means smallest will be first and largest will be, means biggest will be at the last. You can sort numbers, you can sort characters also. So suppose 1 to 10 numbers you are going to sort in ascending order. So 1 will come at first position and 10 will be the last one. If you sort it in a descending order, 10 will come first and 1 will go in the last. Similarly, character A to Z and Z to A. Okay, these are the sorting examples. First, I want to complete this particular table which is shown you on your screen. It is a result. Let me calculate sum of the range from D53 to G53. We will calculate the sum first. I will use autofill feature and drag and drop the fill handle using fill handle. So formula will get copied. Now I will calculate the percentage. For that I will click in the input line. I will start with the equal to symbol. Then how many subjects are there out of 50 50 50 50? See, out of 100 it should record out of 100, not 50. Let me check the grammatical error. Let me cancel this formula first. It should be out of 100. It should be out of 100. So let me change the data quickly. Only column heading only I will change. Now, so 4 subjects of 100 marks each. So this particular student got 340 out of 400. So percentage I will calculate equal to sine total marks divided by 400 into sign of percent symbol can do. So it is 85. I will drag and drop. It is correct, I know. So these are the percentage what we have calculated here. Now let us try to sort the data as per characters in ascending order. So select the column, go to the menu bar, data menu, click on the data menu, go for the sort option, extend selection, name ascending this is already selected by default, so I will click on OK. So it is already in ascending order. See, Rohan A will come first, all the A names, Rohan's R go last. Okay, now let me sort this on the percentage of on the column percent. I want to tell you that I want to find out who scored maximum marks. So maximum marks should come at first position. So definitely I have to sort this data into descending order. So I will click on data, then I will go sort option, extend selection. Now this time I will select descending, then I will press OK. And now easily you can see Rohan scored 85, who is at number one position. Then Radha 84.25 and so on. Okay. So this is already sorted. Sort command is in front of you. Few names are here. The same names, let me show you few names here. I tried all the names using all the characters like A, B, C, D, C for Chandrakant, B for Balaji, O for Om, N for Nilakshi, L for Lalit, Z for Zubair, J for Jay, O for again Ojaswini, Y for Yanshi. Yash, I have already selected. Keep all these data ready in front of you. Now I will select the data, go for the data menu. I will click on sort. This time I want to do something little else. I will click on the options tab. I will click on case sensitive. Then again I will check click on this checkbox, copy sort result to. This time I will select D89, so just column which is adjacent to the column which I have selected. See, data is here, sorted data is there. Abhay come first because A B first, then A J, then A R Arjun, then Babita, Balaji, Chandrakant. You can see easily the data is sorted as per ascending order. Now just go through the filter. See, this is yet another table I kept readily available. Just let me apply some borders and then I will bring into centered aligned way. Okay, now see, few students are there which are residing at Besa, Beltorori, Manyamara Road, Ghogli, Omkar Nagar, like this. Only four areas are there. I want to find out how many students are there residing at Besa. So I will select this particular cell. I will go to the data menu. I will go to the filter option. From there, I will select the sub option, auto filter, and see this drop down arrow marks are assigned on the column headings. I will just select it and I will just pick up the filtered condition. I want Besa. So see, these are the students residing at Besa. If you want Ghogli students, those who are residing only at Ghogli place, so you can go like this. So this is the example of filter. So you can easily filter out the given data or data based on some conditions from very large amount of data. So these two are very important. Last time few students asked me about LCM command and GCD command, LCM function and GCD functions. For that, just I have created one. Yes, this is one special document for you. I want to show you it on the screen. Sort command we have done LCM. See, this is not a maths class, so I will not explain how I calculated the LCM. But you know this LCM for three numbers. 24, 48, 60, just try to divide it, start with the lowest or minimum number 2, then 3, then 4, 5, like that. I have done all these things, so finally I got 240. Least common multiple of these three numbers is 240. Let me implement it practically. For that, I want to start this ODS file. ODS means Open Office spreadsheet file, which I have already shown to you. This is the data 24, then 48, and then the third is 60. So I have entered this, and now let me increase the font size so that it will be clearly visible for all of you. And as I start with the input line equal to sign LCM in bracket, select this range, press enter key, see the 240 answer is in front of you. Now regarding to the GCD, I will take this second example, GCD of 62418. I will show you this GCD process. GCD process is in front of you. See, this one is GCD of 6, 24 and 18. So just factorize 6, 1, 2, 3, 6 are the factors of 6, 24, 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12 and 24 are the factors of 24. Whereas 1, 2, 3, 6, 9, 18 are the factors of number 18. Factorize it. Look at the common factors. 1, 2, 3, 6 are the common factors of 6, 24 and 16, out of which 6 is the largest or biggest or greatest, and hence 6 is the GCD of 6, 24, 18. So let me calculate with the help of GCD function. 6, 24, 18. I will write down here 6, 24 and 18. I will select the cells. I will increase the font size so that you can easily visualize it. And let me again start with the formula by pressing into my cursor into input line, again by pressing equal to sign beginning with GCD, and I will select the range of these three numbers. I will press the enter key. See, the output is 6. So GCD of these numbers is 6. So my dear friends, today we have seen sort command, filtered command, LCM function and GCD function. Okay, I hope you have thoroughly understood it. Please practice it at homes. Open Office Calc is very important concept and topic and program. Please stop, do not stop working on it. Follow VST schedule. In case of any doubt or difficulty, please send it through your class teacher to me. I will definitely solve it. Okay, so wish you all the best. Happy computing. Practice at home. Okay, keep stay fit and healthy. All the best to you. Thank you so much. Bye everyone.